And congratulations to all the fans of the great Oklahoma State Bucks. That's who won the college championships, right? Oklahoma State Ducks or something? Bucks. What was it?
Like
huh?
Dollar bills?
I don't follow college football very well.
Congratulations to the Macho Man, Hall of Fame. Ooh, yeah.
Did he get in the Hall of Fame this year? Did they announce that? I didn't pay attention to that. There's not one mayor of Hollywood who sits down. It's, you know, there's different situations.
I wish there was.
Yes. Mayor Hollywood. He's like, yeah, come before me, like the Wizard of Oz.
No gun girl too.
Sitting on a giant marshmallow.
Yes.
No thank you today.
I nominate John Schnepp as mayor of Hollywood. So,
oh, I got Rennered. That's not a catchphrase.
I have a t-shirt.
Yeah, it's like Ben Affleck. Don't try to Renner me. Right. I'm going to be Batman in this movie and this movie. You're not going to replace it. I'm not getting Rennered.
Garbage.
That's just not, no one's saying that. He's in like, the guy's like in so many films.
Right over there, the mayor of Hollywood, Mr. John Schnepp. Schnepp, where can people find you online?
You find me at Twitter and Instagram at John Schnepp and at TDOSLWH. And I keep looking, every time it cuts to you, you have Meryl Streep behind you. It looks like, just cut over to John for a second. And you see, like, it looks like she's like, I keep hearing the Skype. Like, I'm like, is she looking at him? Like, the eyes keep moving. I keep thinking something's going to happen.
And you have Paddington.
And you have Paddington.
Where's my blender?
Yeah. Schnepp, would you be up for a Jon Stewart? Not talking about the Daily Show?
Sure. No, regardless.
I would like Jon Stewart as Jon Stewart,
now that you brought it up, in the all-comedy version of Green Lantern with Jack Black in it as well. And Robert Schmeichel's got to direct it. A lot of people know who Bruce Wayne is. If you say, who's Bruce Wayne? Oh, he's Batman.
Right.
If you said, who's Hal Jordan? Be like, is he part of the One Direction? Is he one of those guys? He's doing, like, synchronized dancing? You know, it's like...
I actually like the second one. The one with Edward Norton.
So, and me. By the way.
Oh, yes. Yeah. Oh,
that's right.
Co-starring John Campia.
And I love the Hulk. Remember, he had a TV series for 7 years. Bill Bixby wandering around, crying in the corner. Remember that? Like, it was like,
did you ever see the Hulk TV movie with the Hulk and Thor?
Yes, and it's horrible.
I was so awesome. It was awesome. I remember laughing so much when I saw it. And then they did one with Hulk Daredevil.
He's in a ninja suit. Yeah, and then had these weird, like, Terminator glasses.
Oh, yeah, you know? With, like, I think, wasn't the dude who played Sala in Indiana Jones, didn't he play Kingpin?
With these, like, I just had eye exam glasses, like these giant black glasses and a cane. Wasn't bald, he was just, like, floated away in a weird pod at the end.
Late last week, reports came out that Batman vs. Superman was rumored to be splitting into two films. The first would be called Batman vs. Superman Enter the Night, and the second would be Batman vs. Superman Dawn of Justice. It also said the first one would come out in 2015. I haven't heard you guys talk about it and was wondering what your thoughts are. Thanks, and let's have a great 2015.
Okay, I'm going to do my best not to go into full all-out rant mode here, okay? So here's the thing. So that thing came out, and I remember I first saw the picture, and let's bring up that picture. Here's the graphic that everybody is talking about. This image here that you see, Batman versus Superman, part one, Enter the Night, which sounds like a really bad 1970s gay porn title, but whatever, was for October 2015, part two, Dawn of Justice, at its regularly scheduled date. So this image comes out, and I remember I see it, and I was like instantly intrigued. It's like, what's this? This is fairly interesting. Because just on its face value, it's like, will this kind of make sense? It was a really long shoot. Maybe they have enough material that you could split into. We have been speculating on this show for a long time. Hey, you know what? I wouldn't bet on it, but I won't fall over shock if Warner Brothers shocks the world and comes out of Superman. So, by the way, Batman versus Superman, October 2015, baby, and like just shocks everybody, right? I think that would be genius of them to do. So, sure, it kind of fits into this little box, this narrative we've been creating about what could happen. It makes sense. Sure. But that is where my joygasm ended. Because then I'm like, well, what's the source? There's got to be a really cool source. This came out of Warner Brothers. This came out of a guy who we know did this, blah, blah, blah. Here's what this image is. And let's bring this picture up one more time. Let's bring this up. Here's what this picture is. It is a random, unverified, anonymous picture on Imgur that somebody then shared on Reddit. Nobody knows who it came from. There was absolutely no verification to its authenticity, no evidence at all, not a shred of anything to suggest this could be real. There is nothing in the world, and I read every site that ran, well, I couldn't read every site that ran this as a story because every site did, But there was absolutely no shred of evidence to suggest this is anything other than some 14-year-old with moderate Photoshop skills who just put together a graphic and threw it online. Nothing! Nothing at all! And yet, sites picked it up and ran with it as a story. And this is the thing that I, look, I know you guys here are going on this, but I'm so passionate about this topic. The flagrant disrespect that the movie news web sphere, of which I am a part of, and I have been guilty of this in the past. That's part of the reason it gets me pissed off, because I know this is something inadvertently I have done too, and it really irks me. When we show such flagrant disrespect to the movie fan community, when we show such flagrant disrespect to the fans who invest their time in reading our sites, in listening to our podcasts, and in watching our videos, we don't care that we are feeding them what we know full well is total BS. There's not one of these sites that ran this as any kind of a story that they're not intelligent enough to know. They were all far more intelligent enough to know that this was total BS, but they didn't care. They were going to run it anyway and let the speculation run around some fans. They didn't care that they were causing confusion and misinformation with their readers. There was nothing to support that this was real. If there was at least something there that said, actually, this came from a guy who was once a WB employee and is still friends with a lot of people there. That's still not enough, but then you can see why, okay, maybe. There was nothing. And a lot of these websites running these headlines of rumors of Batman versus Superman being split into two. Others, a lot of these headlines were reports claim that blah. Rumors and reports? You made the frickin' rumors and reports! This wasn't a rumor until you started spreading this BS. This wasn't a report until you said it was a report. This is one of those examples where the movie news sphere online created their own big typhoon of confusion for the fans. Why? Because they just wanted the hits. Look, you just want hits. Everybody online wants hits. There's nothing wrong with that. Craving success, that's great. Do what BuzzFeed does. Make fluff pieces. Make top five lists. We all do that. You're not confusing your audience. You're not spreading misinformation. You're just putting up good stuff that gets a lot of hits. And do that. Don't intentionally mislead your readers and the whole damn community. This is what makes our whole industry a joke. Is that guys like you, and look, I know a lot of really good guys who made a mistake. They didn't intentionally do, you know, make mistakes, so I don't want to lump everybody into one thing. That's unfair of me. But there are some people out there who just knew this was total BS. They had no doubt, there was no validity to it, and yet they put it out as a piece of news. The rumors, the reports, you are the rumor and the report. You created it. Let's show some more respect to the people who read our websites and watch our shows. Let's show some more respect to the movie fan community that lets us do what we do because we're a part of them. Let's nurture this and grow it and celebrate it, not treat it like crap.